Welcome. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. I thank God. It's a wonderful to be here in USA, New York. I want to thank God so much, and I praise Him because He is so good. He's so wonderful. Beside everything that the enemy did and tried and make things hard for me, but all in all, we thank God and we give God glory because He is able, and we are not give up. The word of God came to me at this message that I'm going to share with you. Do not be discouraged. Not every day, not all the time that things will be good or will be looking good. Sometimes it's very hard, it's very difficult. But we thank God. Let me try to see to you to just listen. Okay. Yeah, I thank God so much because God has been very, very, very good, very faithful to me. Besides, no matter what you are going through, what people going through, it is always God is good and God is able. I praise God and I thank God who is enable me to be this in this country. And through it was difficult, it was the enemy tried to work very hard to stop me, to block me, to bring destruction, to attack everything. But I decided, I said, I will not give up, I will not be discouraged. So that's the same thing. Maybe you are going through with some problems, some issues, that it will make you to feel like you want to give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. That is the time you push on. That is the time you know how to pursue your enemy. You must pursue your enemy until you defeat him. I pray that this morning God will find you and you will be able to stand up and fight your enemies. Don't give up. Don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged in prayer. Don't ever try to be discouraged. Don't ever try to be discouraged in prayer. Sometimes you feel like you don't want to pray. It is very hard. When you see everything is not working for you, you try this task, nothing is working for you. Don't give up. Keep on. Keep on. Press. Keep on pressing on. Press on. Lord will help you. I saw yesterday when I was coming at the airport, the immigration officer decided to make my life so hard, so really hard. And there was no reason, it's just the enemy uses him. And then I was just looking at him and smile, because I know there is no human being, born of a woman, would stop what I'm doing. They would try, but they would defeat it. So this man was asking me a lot of questions. He asked me, so he started checking everything, my computer, everything that I was having. So I was just looking at him and smile. Now, when I was smiling, he was more mad. He was very mad. Then the two security men, I believe the two policemen came and another lady, there were about four people. So I was looking at them, but I just look at them. So all in all, the man who was leading after my neck, I looked at the man, I said, Mr. Man, you need help, I can help you. Right now you are going to divorce. You have big problem. Your wife is divorcing you and you need help, I can help you. When I told that man like that, the man said, are you a prophet? Are you a prophet? Are you a prophet? I said, yes. Don't you see I'm a prophet? How did I know? Then he looked at me. He stamped my passport and he gave me a visa. And he forgot he gave me a working visa. As if I was going to work. So that's how the Lord opened for me a door. And I thank him. So when the enemy is really attacking you so hard, the blessings of God is coming. So you never give up. God will deliver you in the midst of your enemies. And I want to thank God that God is able to deliver you in the midst of your enemies. When the enemy is broken everywhere, you have nowhere to turn to. You don't have anything. That is the blessings of God is coming. Don't give up in prayer. Continue. Sometimes you don't know even what you can say. You don't know how you can pray. Yes, I understand it is difficult, but press on. Even say, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. When you are being pressed so hard, but hallelujah, praise the Lord, will come in. Paul says, Give thanks all the time. When you are really pressed down, when you are being pressed, you don't know what to do. You have nothing. You don't have any money in your pocket. You have children sick. Everything is standing still. You have been facing so difficult time. Don't forget. Just keep on remembering. Thank God. Say, God, thank you because I know you know the situation I am. Thank you, Lord, for what is happening to me because you are my Father and I know you are there. Continue to pray. You will become stronger and your enemy and you will become weaker. Your enemy will lose. Like what these people, they were attacking me. I was just smiling on them. I was looking at them. They were very serious. You know, security men, they don't joke with people. When they want to attack you, they want to send you back. They want to, they don't joke. They don't laugh. They change their eyes. I was looking at their eyes the way they were very angry. They were very annoyed. So I was looking at them. And this one, they were looking to each other. And I was looking, open my eyes big. I opened my eyes big and I was looking at them. So when I look at them with my eyes, then the more they become angry. So you face the enemy with your eyes and look at the eyes. And in my eyes, I said, you demon, I put you on my feet. You cannot defeat me. I destroy you. So they become weak. They become weak. And then the two security men, the police, they moved together, very close together, like they was whispering, they was talking something. So, and then this one was very angry, was more, and then I look at the man, because I knew that in my spirit, that Lord did not tell me to be disgraced. I would never be disgraced. So, when I look at this man, I say just one word, I finished him. That's how you can apply one weapon. Then it can bring your enemy down. David consumed his enemy. David consumed his enemy. If you want to consume the enemies, read the book of David, of Psalms, how David consumed his enemy. He consumed the enemy and he made sure that the enemy will not breathe, will not even stand. When we look at the book of Psalms 18, verse 37, the book of Psalms 18, verse 37 to 40, the Bible says, I pursued my enemies and I overtake them. David pursued his enemies and overtake them. People of God, when you know what you have, without worrying, without crying, without discouraged, David did not give himself for discouragement. He did not know his vocabulary that there is a word called discouragement. He was going through difficult time like you and me. He could have been discouraged and give up, but he decided, I will never discouraged, no matter what it is. I will pursue my enemies and overtake them. You say, I will pursue my enemies and overtake them in the name of Jesus. David says, I will pursue my enemy and overtake them. I did not turn back until they were destroyed. I crushed them so that they could not rest. David is saying, you will be able to crush your enemy, that they will not be able to rise up. They will fall beneath my feet. So you must know that all your enemy, you have been given power and authority, and your enemy is on your feet. When I was standing with that immigration, I put him in my feet. He could not move. He could not do anything. Yes? You put your enemy, when they confront you, remember that your enemy is on your feet. You can stand on them like this. Yes, in the midst of your trouble and temptation, you just step on your enemy on your feet like this. So, enemy, I will never discourage. Yes, you have come to attack me. In the name of Jesus, you are on my feet. I destroy you. I pursue you. You will never be raised up. So, the Bible says, verse 4, they fell beneath my feet. You harmed me with the strength of battle. You humbled my adversaries before me. You made my enemy turn back in flight, and I destroyed my force. He did not turn until they were destroyed. you must see spiritual enemies completely in the name of Jesus. You must see our spiritual enemies completely destroyed. You must see our spiritual enemy completely destroyed in the name of Jesus. You must see all our enemies, spiritual enemy, completely destroyed. Spiritual enemy, they can attack you in a spiritual way and you have no idea. That's why you must bring them to your feet and make sure that you have destroyed them. The way David is saying in Psalms 18, verse 37 to 40. You must make sure that you have destroyed them. You destroy them is continue praying, continue resisting, continue speaking the word, continue saying, Jesus, I know you defeated the devil. I know I will make it. No matter what circumstances is, no matter what you are facing, stand firm, continue praying. The Lord will see your enemies completely destroyed. You will see with your own eyes. Look at Psalms 91. Your enemy will come 10,000 and another 1,000, but you will see them with your own eyes being defeated. That's why you should not be discouraged. Your enemy will be defeated and be disgraced in Jesus' name. Yes, we must pursue the enemy. You must pursue the enemy. To pursue means to fall in order to overtake and capture. You fall, pursue means you have to follow, you have to pursue means to fall in order to overtake and capture. It means to chase with the host intent. You cannot perceive when it comes to spiritual warfare. It means to chase with the hostile intent. We cannot be passive when it comes to warfare. So you make sure you pursue your enemies. You chase them. You chase them. You cannot, when you get discouragement, when you are discouraged, then you are defeated. But when you pursue them, when you are resisting, and then you will chase them. They don't want that. If that immigration officer, I was shaken all because he was asking me so stupid nonsense question, some confusing question, so that you can make mistakes. Let your enemy make a mistake that will move you forward. When you are being caught, in case the enemy has caught you and he is interrogating you, don't panic, don't give up, don't shake. Remember straight away the one word that is on your feet. And stand with your feet strong and tell him that you are on my feet no matter what you are. Yes, you found me in your camp, or you got me. But in the name of Jesus, you will be destroyed. They will make you to look like you have done something. They will make you to commit offense that you have never committed. Because they confuse you, they start interrogating you, they start talking you, and put the word upon words. Then because you fear, because the enemy always brings fear, he will start mocking you. They will mock you badly. Yeah? A person was confronting me one time that pastors are thieves, criminal. I don't want to hear any pastor around me. So, and I was there, I'm a pastor, I'm one of the pastors. So she was talking bad. And then I said, I am a pastor. I am not what I am. I'm not what you are saying. That's not Jesus. It's the devil talking. So I'm not going to give any chance. I'm not going to give you. Yes, there are pastors who are criminal or crooked, wherever they are, but I am not the one. I am not the one. So I'm not going to give you any permission or anything to attack me. In the name of Jesus Christ, I am now standing to rebuke and stop enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. So I refuse, because the more you give the enemy chance, the more he will defeat you. So you have to stand firm and refuse. He will threaten you, really, he will make you to fail, to look a fool. He will make you that you commit, you accept something you didn't commit. That's why you find many people, they go to prison because of this. They come with fear. They make you fear. When you fear, then you are finished. you feel guilty for no reason. They will confront you. They will use bad words to provoke you. Whenever they say anything the enemy is saying is just treat it negative. Treat nothing. Make sure that you don't give any chance when you get offended, when you get angry, when you feel bad. They will call you names. Yeah? One time, I was driving. And then, you know, in the road, there's some things happening. And another driver crossed me very fast. And another one was coming. But through the grace of God, there was nothing, but the person escaped. The other person started saying, "Where did you get your driving license? These are the one who buying the driving license in the street." The person started cursing the other man. And the other man said, "He's so sorry, because you are on the road. You are a used roaders. Anything can happen. You did, the person did not do anything intentionally. But you know, when something has happened, nothing has happened, thank God, God." So now what happened? This man delayed me until I missed my flight. But I knew that even though I missed the flight, I'm not going to complain. I have won the victory. I have disgraced him. He looked useless. He looked stupid. I have win. So you have to stand firm. You have to stand firm no matter. Don't give the demon of fear to enter in you. Don't give the enemy to the demon of discouragement to enter in you. Don't give up. Don't give up. If you can fast and pray, go ahead. If you cannot be able to, because you have been fixed, you have been tormented, you cannot be able even to pray, even to say a word, just say hallelujah, praise the Lord. Remember your feet, look at your feet and say, "Oh, even though wherever it's happening, you are still in my feet. You are going to be defeated." Look at what David did. David is victorious, prepare the way for Solomon's. Solomon enjoyed peace and prosperity. Solomon's name means peace, prosperity, favor, healthy, well healthy, and well-being. You are victorious over the enemy will release Shalom. You will experience great levels. You will experience great level of peace, prosperity. That's why David really worked so hard for his generation. The battle that the day was very furious, and Abinah, the man of Israel, was defeated by David's men. In the book of 2 Samuel 2 verse 17, Abinah was defeated by the men of David. Abinah of Israel. Abinah, the man of Israel, was defeated by David's men. 2 Samuel 2, 17. "For to us a child is born, to us a child is given, and the garment will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Peace of Peace," in the book of Isaiah 9, verse 6. Everlasting, the child has born. Yes? The child has born. Isaiah 9 verse 6. The Bible says, "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the garment will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counsel, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. He makes war cease the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatter the spear. He burned the shield with fire." Psalms 46 verse 9. Psalms 46 verse. "He makes wars to cease the end. The earth, he breaks the bow, shatters the spear. He burns the shield with fire." You release the fire of God to the camp of the enemy. Releasing the fire of God, you pray like this. "Your throne, O Lord, is like a furious flame. The throne of God is like a fire, is a furious flame." Daniel 7 verse 9. "Remember the fire of God. Send the fire of God to the camp of the enemies. Call fire. Fire will pursue your enemies. You are the God that answer by fire. Remember that you are a God that answer by fire. Answer me by fire. Don't, instead of worrying, thinking negative, being angry, yeah, being offended. Remember, God, you are a God who answer by fire. First King 18:24. God answer by fire. Call Almighty God who answer by fire to answer you by fire in Jesus' name. A fire goes before you, O Lord, and burn your enemies. Psalms 79. The fire of God go before the enemy and burn them. When you use fire, that is very good. Thank you, treasure. A fire goes before you, O Lord, and burns up your enemies. So the fire goes before you and burn your enemies. You have to use fire. Fire does not care. When a fire entered their place, it burned them to ashes. No matter what it is. That's why we use a lot of fire all the time. We use fire. Thank you, Lord. I thank God that God is able. That is the still the fire of God is working and is doing the work. Still the fire of God, the same fire of Elijah is still here. When you send the fire to consume the camp of the enemy cannot do anything. They will burn to ashes. Lord, release your fire and burn up. Baptize me with the Holy Ghost and the fire. Ask the baptism of Holy Ghost. Luke 3:16. The Bible says in Luke 3:16 said he will baptize you with the fire, with the Holy Ghost and fire. Ask God, baptize me with the Holy Ghost fire. Ask me to baptize with the Holy Ghost fire. Yes. You ask God to baptize you with the Holy Ghost fire. When you are down, when you are discouraged, the Holy Spirit will fall upon you. The Holy Spirit will provide everything you want. No matter discouragement, no matter what is going on around you, just ask the Holy Spirit. Say, my inner man, receive fire. My inner man, receive fire. Call fire of God. That's when you are discouraged, you have no hope. Remember, don't stand crying, mourning. Don't stand negative. Don't be angry. Don't be aggressive. You will open the enemy the door to defeat you. Just say you well wherever you had, my inner man receive fire. Receive fire. Receive fire. When you call fire, then you release the fire to the enemy, they will burn down and leave you. Don't let the enemy to put you in a place where you are not supposed to be. The enemy, when he catches you and puts the spirit of fear, he can arrest you, he can do anything he wants. When Paul was arrested, Paul and Silas, they were beaten and they were arrested. What did they do? They didn't go to mourn, they didn't go to beat themselves, they didn't go to negative. They did not ask, say, God, I'm serving you so hard. God, I'm doing this. Why am I being in prison? Why I was being put here? What? They said, yes, hallelujah. They started praising God and calling upon God of Abraham, God of Isaac. They say, God, we want to see your glory. Through me, people, prisoners are going to be saved. Through me, even this the prisoner warden, the prison officers, they will be saved. And for sure, those people were saved. If Paul were angry, if Paul was so mad, do you know that immigration officer, he picked my card, my business card, after I mentioned to him, he turned to be enemy, but through me now, God is going to use him. He's going to call me and I will pray for him. Yeah? He took the card. When he just is asking me, are you a prophet? If I was angry because they mocked me, they were talking to me bad, he was questioning me, but I was looking at him and I smiled. And I know that he's on my feet. He can't escape. At the end, it is time to be joy and happy. Yeah? So if I said, I missed my flight, you don't have to give a chance to the devil. And through missing the flight, I made a divine connection. I got a media very important person at the airport when I was waiting. And God was good. The next flight, I was able to get a seat there. So I didn't miss anything. Instead, I got blessing. If I was angry and saying, oh, what is this? I could lose everything. But God is good. I thank God that God is so good. God is so good. Through missing my flight, He gave me a divine connection. So, when you are discouraged, don't give up. Don't give in to discouragement. No matter what you are going through right now, continue resisting the devil. The Bible says, and he will flee away. Stand firm. Stand still. You will see the salvation. Never give up. Yes, you might go very tough situation right now, but God is a provider. The Bible says, where there is no way, the Lord will open a way for you. Hallelujah. God is good. Let your fire be in my hands to heal the sick and cast out the devilish in Jesus' name. Let the fire fall upon your hands and heal the sick. When you lay your hands on sick people, they will be healed. When you just put your hand like this, miracle will start happening. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let fire burn my eyes, my heart, my belly, and my mouth, and my feet. Pray like that. Let fire burn my eyes, my heart, my belly, my mouth, and my feet. When fire burn your eyes, when you look at the enemy, that fire from your eyes will just work miracles without even talking. When I was looking at that security man, I was looking him seriously. The way he was looking at me, my mind was fire briquette. I was just looking at him. Yes, yes. Then the man was looking at me because the way I was talking and the way I met him more angry. Yeah. So if you don't know what you are doing, they would bring you down and disgrace you. They could have returned me back. That's what they do, and they hate the preachers. They hate pastors so much. One pastor was being held in an airport, and he has to call home office. He has to do they put him in jail because the enemy could do you anything to make sure that you are a liar, to look like a liar. And them, they are the best liar. So the enemy would mistreat you yourself to accept these lies. Don't accept the lies of the devil. He will accuse. It's the accuse of your brethren. It's the accuse of the brethren. He's called an accuser. He can accuse you and take everything from you. So when you are being, you call fire fall in my hands. Fire fall in my heart. Fire fall on my mouth. Fire fall on my feet. When you are fire fall on your feet, that demon that you are stepping on, if it cannot rest up. That's why you call God. Fall my heart. Because when you fear comes, your heart starts beating you. Then your heart beats you very fast. Now the enemy says, okay, I'm going to squeeze the breath from her, from him. Then he starts squeezing you. Then you get mad, it goes to your head. So that's why you need the fire enter and destroy everything the enemy is putting on you. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Let your fire be in my tongue. To preach and prosper and prophesy. Let fire come to my tongue. When I speak, the word will go like machine gun and burn down everything. I will prophesy by fire. The word of God that come by fire from my mouth, it will do what God has said, no matter what it is. I will speak the word and the word will do what I've said. Says the Lord. Hallelujah. I receive tongues of fire in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. My God, I want to thank you, Jesus. This morning, I want to glorify you. I want to honor you. I want to glorify your name. here in my in a place I really thank God for everything. That God is able and they can, there's no demon from the pit of hell will stop the work of God that God has given me. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, my Father. You say, God, in Psalms 18:13, deliver me, God, with your fire. Ask God to deliver you. Use the fire. If you don't remember things, remember fire always in your mouth. Fire is the best weapon that you can ever use. Thank you, my sister. Hallelujah. Let your fire protect me and cover me. Let your fire protect me and cover me. In Exodus 14:24, the fire of God will cover you. The wall of fire will round your house, will round everywhere where you are. When you are being attacked, when you feel discouraged, ask the fire of God to cover you. Ask the fire of God to cover your children. Ask the fire of God to fall upon you right now. You need fire. Yes. You say, oh my God, fire of God protect me. Fire of God, blood of Jesus. Blood of Jesus with the fire protect me. Fire of God. When the fire is protecting you around you are in the midst, in the middle, what would happen? Can anybody come to fire? Nothing. That's how it is. So you don't have to fear. Call fire of God. My God, my Father, I called fire. I was praying for a lady in Australia. And this lady was she has been sick for 50 years. She has never gone out. She has never enjoyed it. She's so sick. She doesn't die. So the demon, the enemy, decided to torment her the rest of her life. That after I prayed the woman, I asked angels, assistance angels from heaven to come. Immediately, I saw thousands of angels coming to that woman's house. And the woman was healed. The woman was healed the first time she was able to stand and she feel fresh, she feel relieved. After those demons who was attacking her for 50 years, I'm telling you that God is able. Don't be discouraged. I know some of you, many people are discouraged today. But my message is this. Remember you have fire. Call fire when you are defeated. You know when you are defeated, you have no fire. So remember to renew your spirit, your mouth, your heart, everywhere with fire. Remember, call fire. Remember, my inner man, receive fire. My inner man, just pray that prayer point. When you are defeated, you have no nothing, you don't know what to do. Start saying, my inner man, receive fire. If you can speak in tongues, pray in tongues. Don't pray any word. Don't use any word. Just speak the word. It will be established. If you can speak in tongues, pray in tongues. If you cannot speak in tongues, say, my inner man, receive fire. My inner man, receive fire. Even if you are in the midst of your enemy, even if you are in the midst of your the camp of the enemy, the fire will come and destroy your enemies. You will be able to pursue them and they cannot deliver themselves. That is fire of God. I release the fire of God to burn out the idols of the land in the name of Jesus Christ. I release the fire. The book of Deuteronomy 7:5. I release the fire. Thank you for the lady who gave me that scripture. Thank you. I release the fire of God to burn up the idols of the land in Jesus' name. When I came here in New York, I take authority. I take over New York immediately. I take dominion and I command every demon, everything living here, in this time when I'm here, they will be arrested. No one will rise up. I take dominion over them. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is God. I want to thank God. I want to thank you. We have been given dominion, power and authority. So you can bring the demons down to your feet and arrest them. Everything the enemy is planning against you shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. Because you have been given authority and dominion. You have been given authority and the authority that the immigration officers have, than the authority that the judges have, than the authority that even the president of the world has. The authority you have is so powerful. you can bring that bracelet down. You can, if you know who you are, I'm telling you, you will have peace. You will have peace and prosperity. That poverty is a great enemy. You have been suffering a lot. So your time is up. That when you will rise up and stop the enemy in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Father, I want to thank you. My battery is going down. I didn't charge my, I think I forgot my charger. So I will get the charger and do it and continue. God bless you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. God bless you, God bless you. Please, treasure, pull up the prayer number. People can see. Call us, reach us on email. Pray for us. I pray for you too. I thank God so much. Yes, poverty is bad, my brother. I want to pray that God will bless you and release prosperity and health in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. See you. I have not, my schedule is so much busy, so I don't know, but I will come. If I don't come, yes, midnight I will be on. Tomorrow, not today. Today we don't have midnight. Tomorrow, Monday, we have four nights. Midnight, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Then we have day, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Sunday. We don't have midnight today. We have midnight tomorrow, Monday. So don't call, don't call, because we will not be on midnight tonight. So God bless you so much. People who are living in New York, I am here. Call me, my number, my cell phone number. You know my cell phone number. 647-608-5207. Call this number. It's working. To make appointment. If you are living in New York, you want to meet me, I bring the blessings to you. You call me. Then my number is 647-608-5207. I go by appointment. I'm not telling you where I am. I am living in New York in a hotel. So when you call me, I will give you the hotel number. So my name is Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. So call my number. Don't call my hotel. My son David don't give anybody the hotel number. So I go by appointment. I'm here until Thursday. So if you call now, you book appointment by me. You call me, I will schedule you. So if you don't call me, that's fine. Thank you so much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time, and God see you tomorrow night. Bye bye. God bless you. I love you so much, and there's nothing I can do about it. So see you tomorrow midnight. Tomorrow 12 midnight. Have a wonderful time. Remember to call me for appointment. Now my number is 647-608-5207. Thank you so much. I live in Canada, but right now I'm in the States. I'm in New York. And maybe I might go to New Jersey, but I will let you. My number is working, so don't worry. Just call me. Okay? Thank you. Have a wonderful time. Bye.